in this laboratory, we're trying to understand and take some of the unpredictability out of fire by doing experiments in well-controlled environments. We are studying how fires initiate.
We look for patterns in the flames, whether they merge, whether they don't merge, how the flames are behaving, how they interact with each other.
And we're doing it at a small scale, and hopefully that gives us some insight into what happens at a large scale. There's some fairly good models already for how dried grass burns, but nobody knows how these shrubs burn, and that's when the fire gets unpredictable. The thing that's hard to model with the shrub is the geometry, how it grows from a few inches into a 6 or an 8 foot flame. How does that happen? We don't know.
We study how these plants burn to see what chemicals are inside the leaves and then what chemicals are released when they are burning.
When something burns, it first gives off gases, and they are the things that really burn, and we see a flame like that. It's not really the solid. We have done both experiments of burning leaves and looking at flame behavior.
We conduct these experiments with ceramic felt pads. They take the place of the leaves, so we put them in different configurations, set them on fire, and we watch the flames as they burn.
We needed to know, when these two flames intersect, what happens to that flame? Does it double in volume or change its width?
After that, we run it through a computer code that calculates the height of the flame, width of the flame, the area of the flame, and also whether the flames on the two pads are merging.
So if we can focus down to the very small scale, then we can work up to trying to model that. Right now, the models that try to simulate fire use very sophisticated models of the velocity, but hardly know anything about the chemistry of what's coming off the fuel and how it burns. Very detailed models take up to 2 weeks to run. By that time, the fire has moved. We're trying to do an intermediate scale model that runs quick enough for it to be useful for, say, a fire manager that says, where's this fire gonna be in 4 hours? We try to do the best we can to save lives and save homes.